Hey, thanks for tuning in to TWANGnBANG. This is the AR500 Armor Freeman plate carrier, and it comes with a pair of plates just like this for an MSRP of only $119. I do want to start this video by addressing the elephant in the room, which might be more appropriately called the mouse in the room. Yes, this is very small at only 9 inches by 9 inches and not very square. While it provides enough coverage for my heart and its major blood vessels, it's not going to provide as much coverage as a 10 by 12 or 11 by 14 plate. However, the Freeman isn't designed to be your primary body armor. Instead, it's designed to give you access to rifle-rated armor in situations where having a full-size plate carrier might either be impractical or out of the reach of your budget. And that's why it's what's coming up next on Twang and Bang. The Freeman is a minimalist plate carrier that's designed around 9-inch by 9-inch octagonal level 3 AR500 steel plates. The front is made of laser-cut laminate cordura with 6 rows of MOLLE-compatible slots that allow placement of up to 3 magazine pouches. The remaining fabric panels are 500D cordura, bar-tacked at all strap connections for durability. Plates are held in place with a genuine Velcro top flap with loop fabric on the front and back panels for ID patches. The shoulder straps are Hypalon, again backed by Velcro and generously reinforced with grid stitching. The side straps feed through US-made side release buckles ending in strap keeper loops. Though the plate carrier is made in Vietnam, all plates and pads made by AR500 Armor are made in the US. The specially cut plates weigh 5 pounds each and are available in either curved or flat configurations. Matching trauma pads are also available, though none were available for me to test. Here's what the Freeman looks like compared to the Micro and Veritas plate carriers. Two examples of minimalist plate carriers I've shown on my channel before. The Micro is what I currently have in my get home bag, and it takes 8 by 10 inch plates pretty handily. The 9 by 9 plates of the Freeman are both wider and shorter, obviously, but you can see that there's a bit of difference in the coverage, at least along one side, once you get them aligned. The cuts here are about the same. Compared to the Veritas, the Freeman's compactness really stands out. And I'm not just talking about the plates. The lack of buckles and pads on the shoulders, the lack of pockets, and the thin side straps cut not just weight, but also a significant amount of bulk and size off the carrier itself. Forget the difference in the size of plates. The Freeman carrier is barely bigger than the two plates it holds. That doesn't mean the Freeman is without important features. Though it doesn't have MOLLE loops, it does have a Cordura shell that's laser cut with 6 rows of MOLLE compatible slots for adding mag pouches, IFAX, and yes, even pockets if you really want them. Internally, the Freeman also lacks stabilizing straps, but since it only accepts one size plate, it doesn't really need them. Interestingly enough though, that fact allows the Freeman to have plate pouches that open at the top because the plates will always sit with their top edges at the top of the pouches. Gravity then does the heavy lifting, so to speak, in keeping the plates in place, though tightly sealing the flaps also helps considerably. Ordinarily, I recommend curved plates for those who can afford the option, but I actually think the flat plates are the way to go for the Freeman because they stack into a very thin package compared to curved plates. This whole set fits into my courier bag no problem, leaving plenty of room for my laptop and chargers and a whole bunch of other stuff. Plus, it lays flat just like my laptop does, so it doesn't look like I've got anything out of the ordinary while I'm carrying it. I don't really wear backpacks anymore unless I'm hauling camera equipment. The Freeman actually fits just fine in my cheapy Amazon camera bag with my camera and lenses all in place. And this isn't a very big backpack at all. Well, I am using my cameras and a couple of the lenses and the microphones, but you can see that they'd fit in those spaces just fine with the Freeman on the top. That's actually pretty cool. I've been keeping my Micro plate carrier and armor in my Vanquist Racket 36 get home bag for years, but these curved plates barely stuff in the outer pocket. I could easily keep 2 Freeman armor sets in the same pocket, one for me and one for a friend or family member. That's actually one of the best reasons to go with something like this Freeman for a get home bag, because you'll probably have somebody with you that you want protected. And with two armor sets instead of just one, you won't have to choose between armoring yourself as the person who'll be doing the fighting if it came to that, or armoring the person you're trying to protect. I've often said that body armor is always a trade-off between mobility and protection, but I'm usually talking about wearing body armor. The Freeman made me realize that we are making that trade-off every day, all day, with regards to access to body armor. Full-size plate carriers and armor are just too cumbersome to be carrying around with us wherever we go, so we end up without access to body armor in favor of mobility. The Freeman gives us the option of carrying around rifle-rated body armor in a backpack or a briefcase while still having enough room for all the other stuff we need to carry around with us. Body armor is never easy to put on fast, and you can forget doing it while keeping your hat on. But the size and weight of the Freeman makes this some of the fastest body armor to get in place. Makes it a pretty good choice for a bump in the night set of body armor when you might not ordinarily take the time to put on a full-size plate carrier. I think the Freeman makes a great choice for up armor for a law enforcement officer or security personnel who might already be wearing level 2 soft body armor. I'm 5'8", about 180 pounds, and I'm actually wearing ultra-high molecular weight polyethylene hard plates, which are super thick, just to give you an idea of how much adjustability there is in the Freeman. There's still plenty of adjustment left in the shoulder straps and the side straps. You can be a really big guy and still have enough adjustability in a Freeman to get it over you and your body armor. The Freeman can accept the plates either side up, depending upon your coverage priorities. I wear mine upside down because I feel like that gives me broader coverage at my actual center of mass while providing extra mobility in the arms, which are going to be providing ballistic protection of their own anytime I'm aiming a long gun or a pistol. It's really obvious when I'm aiming a long gun like my Bravo Company SBR. You can see that in order to reach the gaps in the body armor, a bullet would have to pass through my arm or my SBR or both, no matter what my orientation is. Same thing with aiming a pistol. You can see how my shoulders and arms roll in front of the gaps at the top. Yeah, I'm not going to get that extra coverage just standing around and not shooting back, but if I had the plates oriented the other way, I wouldn't get any extra coverage for what would then be the gaps at the lower corners, no matter what I did. There's no objective way, though, to know which is going to be the best way to orient these plates as far as your protection goes, but you should give it a little bit of thought rather than just throwing the plates in the carrier based upon which way the labels are. There is one other use of the Freeman that I haven't mentioned yet, and that's in matches that require you to wear body armor. The Freeman might allow you to follow the rules while giving you an advantage in mobility. Of course, it's up to you to decide whether your priority is placing well in a match or practicing with your gear in a stressful environment. I'm firmly in this camp, so I'm going to wear my full-size plate carrier anyway, but I can't blame somebody from wanting to gain a competitive advantage by wearing the Freeman. Starting at an MSRP of only $119, the Freeman does place extra sets of body armor into the budgets of more people. But for me, it's the form factor that makes this so appealing as secondary armor. It's small enough to fit in a go-home bag, in a backpack, in a briefcase, in a seat back in your car, in a drawer, while still giving you room for stuff to put in the drawer. If it hits the fan and I have access to a full-size plate carrier, I'm not going to be reaching for this. But if it hits the fan and I'm somewhere where I would never have a full-size plate carrier, the Freeman's going to give me access to rifle-rated body armor, and that's going to be way better than nothing at all. Be sure to use the links in the video description and pinned in the comments and code TWANGnBANG to save up to 10% off at AR500 armor. I'm active most days on Facebook and Instagram. You can see the links right here. Be sure to sign up for my mailing list because it's the only way to stay in touch with me no matter what happens to my content here on YouTube. I really appreciate you watching TWANGnBANG, and I hope to see you next time.